It's week 8. We're at 5 points. We're gonna start the week out in 5th place. We're 4 points away from 4th. Let's get in there, get some chips. This is probably the biggest tournament that we've played in the past 2 years here. We final table, we're in the top 3, most likely. A lot of pressure. Let's get in there. Welcome to Vineland Poker League, week 8.
Texas Dolly Brunson, who wrote the book.
He's moving in for the kill.
And there it is. Helmuth wins the championship.
Moneymaker puts his name amongst the greatest players in the game.
Wake me now.
Greg Merson is the main event champion.
Biggest day of my life.
So something's wrong with my GoPro batteries. I usually have 2 and use one and have the other one on the charger. One of them's not working and the one that is working wasn't fully charged. So we are on first break. I have about 30,600 chips. I will start filming hands after this break. GoPro batteries are killing me. How many chips you got?
That's the man. I'm over the starting set.
Okay. All right, so you can move up from like 25th to 18th today.
I'm at 15th.
Oh, nice. So doing what we have to do, right about 30,000. We're up 1 big blind. Short break, so let's get back in there. And now I'll show you hands, I promise. With blinds at 250, 500, it slowly folds around to Tony, who limps in. Bobby O limps in as well in the hijack, and Matt G makes it 1,500 in the cutoff, which is scary because he's one of the top 3 tightest players in this field. Kenny folds on the button, and I complete anyway in the small blind with King Jack of Diamonds because let's see a flop for a little discount. Bruce folds his big blind, and Tony calls, and Bobby folds. We go 3 ways to a flop. And that flop smacks me in the mother ding-dong and face when it comes 2-8-3, all diamonds.
You're everything.
I check, Tony checks, and Matt G, the original raiser, c-bets for 2,000. I fake tank for a few seconds and decide to raise to 56.25. Matt is tight, but I'm pretty sure I'm good here. I put him on queens or aces with maybe a diamond. Tony gets out of the way, and Matt G calls my raise. The turn comes to 4 of hearts, and I just rip it in. I have to try to win this hand now in case he actually has aces with a diamond, because this player is definitely capable of folding that on a brick turn card. But who knows? He could call with 2 red queens. He gets out of the way, and I happily take it down. Ding dong! With blinds at 300, 600, Bruce on my left makes it 1,300 under the gun. It folds all the way around to me in the big blind, and I'm not going anywhere. I call, and we go heads up to a flop. That flop comes 3 of hearts, 4 of hearts, ace of spades. We both check, and the 9 of spades hits the turn. We both check for the second time, and the 10 of hearts hits the river, and he bets 1,500. I do have absolutely nothing here, and when he bets 1,500, I don't try to make a move because I feel like Bruce won't ever believe me. So I let my hand go. Medio from across the table says this was a boring vlog hand, and I should delete it.
Boring vlog.
8 high. But spoiler alert, I unfortunately won't be showing you many hands today, so here's a boring one for you. Good hand, Bruce. Blinds are still at 300, 600, and it folds to Kenny on the button. He raises to 1,500, and I call. Bruce folds his big blind, and we go heads up to a flop against Kenny with queen 9 of hearts. The flop comes 6-6-4 with 2 spades. I check, and Kenny c-bets for 1,500. With 2 overs and a backdoor flush draw, and especially because it's against Kenny, I'm not going anywhere. I call, and the ace of diamonds hits the turn. I check for a second time, and to my surprise, he checks back. The 8 of hearts hits the river, and now there's only one way to win this hand with queen high. I throw in a pink chip and verbalize a 4,000 chip bet, and as I feared, Kenny basically beats me into the pot with the call. He turns over 2 black 10s, and we lose a sizable pot to a guy who's lately becoming our number 1 enemy. Back up off me, bro. I've been losing chips, so let's win them back, or at least try to. With blinds at 300, 600 still, it folds to Kenny in the hijack, who limps in, and I look down at a somewhat average hand in the cutoff. Just a couple of aces, no big deal.
Tonight, aces is the best starting hand in hold'em. This is your time. This is aces. Go out there and take the pot.
Kenny limped in, and he's most likely calling with any 2 cards. so I opt for a bigger sizing. I raise to 3,000, it quickly folds around to Kenny, and you'll never guess what he does. He folds. Ugh, tragic. On to the next.
Come on, Kenny.
That was a nice hand, I had a nice hand. Ooh. Why'd you raise so much?
Because I thought you would make 8,500 with 10-8 off suit.
Come on, that's one time I did it to you.
At 400-800, it folds to me, and I make it 2,000 in the cutoff with queen-8 suited. Bruce on the button calls, the players in the blinds fold, and we go heads up to the 9-8-3 rainbow flop. That's a somewhat good flop for me. I have an over to the board, a pair, and a couple of back doors. So when he bets 2,000, I float a street, and I'm looking to get lucky. The five of diamonds on the turn shouldn't change much, I don't think. So I check again, and he checks back, which is a good sign. The nine of hearts hits the river, which I think is actually a lovely card. A second nine on the board makes it less likely that he has one. But when I check for a third time and he bets 3,000, I snap him off, hoping I'm good, and he shows me ace nine of clubs. Nice river card, Bruce, even though I was probably calling you on a different river card anyway. Nice hand. The hand before dinner break at 400-800 blinds, it folds to me, and I raise to 2,800. Kyle calls, and we go heads up to a flop. Medio deals the 5-3 king, 2 club flop, and we both check. The 9 of diamonds hits the turn, I check, and Kyle checks back for a second time. The river comes the 4 of spades, and after I check for a third time, Kyle bets out 2,000, and I raise him to 5,500, hoping to get him off a weak made hand or a bluff, because checking the whole time and then betting small on the river looks pretty weak to me, so I make a move with my ace-queen. He thinks about it for some time, but does put in the call, and he turns over red queens for the win, and we lose a good amount of chips right before dinner break.
When in Rome.
Dinner break chip counts, week 8.
I have more chips than I started with.
A 79. Correction, 71.9.
66.
64.5.
56.
50-ish.
48.
47.8.
46,000.
45,000.
43,000.
41.
40,000.
38.
36,7.
36,000.
They've been chipping away at me. 33.
33.
32.
30 grand.
29.7.
29.
22,800.
22,000, should I say?
22.
21,000.
I have 20,525.
8K.
3,500.
Well, that last level could have gone better. I peaked at about 40K after that hand with queen 8 against Bruce and my ace queen getting cracked by queens. We're gonna come back after dinner break at 500, 1,000 blinds with 20 big blinds, but it'll be fine. Just find a good spot, double up. We'll have 40K plus and we'll be in a good spot again. Tim's already out, so that's really good. Jason was down to like 10K. He's back above 30K. Jesse was down too, and he went runner, runner, bigger boat over a turned boat, which sucked. Dave is in the 30s and Matt's in the 30s. There's one person out above us, and there's not really any huge stacks with those other people that are on the in the top five with us. We just got to get lucky, pick our spots, and hold. Let's get it. Let's eat some dinner. Week 7 dinner. We have a house salad, and we have a heaping portion of tilapia franchise. Apparently, it was on the special menu today. Looks like Tony picked a good one. I'm really not that hungry. We're going to try it. Probably going to bring it back to Caitlin's and give you a review there. But it looks really good. Definitely a healthy portion. I'm nervous because I'm not doing well in the tournament. Wasn't really hungry to begin with. I had some of it. It's a 6.17. Wasn't as good as the salmon Italiano. What can I say? Coming back from dinner with only 20 bigs, it's time to make some moves and chip up. After a limp or two, Kenny raises to 2,700, and I shove my 16K stack in the middle at 500 1K blinds. It quickly folds around the table, including Kenny, the original raiser, and we take the pot down, even though we really wanted a call with our ace king. A double up would be so nice right now. At 600, 1200 blinds, it folds to me after Kyle under the gun limps, and I raise to an obnoxious 4,600 on the button with king 10. Bruce calls me quickly in the small blind, Dave folds in the big blind, and Kyle, the original limper, calls as well. There's a lot of chips in the middle, and we go three ways to a flop. I deal the jack 7 queen, 2 club flop, which is pretty good for me. I have a backdoor flush draw and an open-ended straight draw. Bruce leads for 5,000, Kyle calls, and I just can't go anywhere yet. I don't have many chips behind, but let's gamble and hit a draw here. The turn comes a 6 of clubs, bringing me closer to a flush. Bruce checks, Kyle checks, and I decide to check back. The river completes the runner-runner flush. The 2 of clubs. Bruce checks, and now Kyle's reaching for chips. He announces 7,000, and I just don't believe him, so I call. He's subbing for his brother Zach, and I've never played with him until today. Bruce angrily tosses his cards across the table and folds, and Kyle shows down the nut flush, ace of clubs, king of spades. I lose almost all my chips here, and I'm left with peanuts.
She doesn't even go here!
Do you even go to this school?
No.
I just have a lot of feelings. Okay, go home.
With blinds at 600, 1200, I have 500 chips left in my stack. Less than a small blind. I shove it in when it folds to me with King 10. Bruce calls, Medio calls, and Tony calls. We separate the side pot from the main and see I can win a 3200 chip main pot, which will feel like so much more than the 500 chips I just had. Let's win. Kyle deals the ace 5-4 two diamond flop and everyone checks. The turn is the six of spades and it checks around again. The river comes the three of hearts and I'm pretty sure I'm dead now. Medio bets 2500, Tony folds, and Bruce raises to 10,000. Medio quickly calls and Bruce shows down a six high straight with jack deuce off. Medio shows down a 7 high straight and wins the pot, knocking me out in 32nd place. This finish drops me down from 5th to 9th in the standings. We have work to do, but we're still very much alive to win a WSOP main event seat. See you next week, guys.
Oh no!
Ah! Alright, so I must admit, week 8 was... It was pretty bad. It was my worst finish of the year. It wasn't a great video, but you just wait. You just wait for weeks 9, 10, 11, and 12 to come out, because those weeks, I promise you, are bangers. Awesome videos coming soon. Thanks for watching. See you soon, guys.
He's laughing. He's having a good time. Good for you. Yeah, laugh it up. Enjoy your night.
Jeez. Shout out to Jesse, who's just sun running in the first 8 weeks of the Vineland Poker League. He has a 120-point lead on second place. I'm not going to say he locked up his main event seat, but he's close.